Savannah, Georgia this morning to do some sourcing for my reselling business. Gonna see what we can find at Pawnshops. I'm gonna hit some thrift stores and maybe some others and just see if we can find anything good. This is how I make a living, so it's important that we find some good profitable stuff on this trip. It's gonna be fun. So I've never really spoken into the camera before or put my face on camera, so prepare for this whole video to be awkward. My first stop is this hardware store. It's about 45 minutes onto my 2-hour journey. Furniture cleaner with the white dresser. It's supposed to be good, but I haven't had any luck with it. So, ended up getting everything. Had trouble at the register because they weren't ringing up the right price because they're so old, but got it all straight. Got what I wanted. Good first stop. Hopefully there's more of the same. Okay, we just got stop number 2. It's a pawn shop. Pawn shops are my favorite because they offer the biggest reward, in my opinion. I ran a pawn shop for 10 years before reselling for myself, so I might be a bit biased, but let's see what we can find. Goose egg. Biggest reward, biggest failure rate on that one. Stop number 3 is this next pawn shop. Let's see what's good. Another bust. That store had almost nothing. All right, stop number 4 is this Ace Hardware. Looks like a new store. These have been very popular. A few of them. Stop number 5. See what we can do. You said get that one. If there's one thing I know about this business, it's sometimes you strike out a lot more than you score, and persistence pays off, so we just got to keep going on to the next one. Got a good feeling about this one. Hopefully we come across something we can make some money on. Let's see, no home runs, but we did find a couple of things. Battery chargers are bread and butter. This one costs $10 here, and it'll sell for 30 bucks maybe. And then I got these. They had, $69 on the price tag. We negotiated it down to 50, and they sell for about $130, so we should double our money after fees and everything. Not too bad on this one. All right, time to go to our first thrift store. See how it goes. No dice at that thrift store either. Thrift stores are not my forte. Stop number 7, or 8, or 6. I think that guy
good one. Called a nibbler. It's for cutting sheet metal, and that's gonna be a pretty good buy if we can get it down to $100 bill, maybe.
Pretty good haul from that one, guys. Look, we got them. Should clear $150-$200 just on that stop by itself. On to the next one. Put another goose egg on the board. Nothing at that one. It's kind of been a day for hardware stores, so this ace looks promising. Let's give it a go. Another goose egg. One of them days. Don't usually do too well at the kind of the off-brand hardware stores, but here we are. We're gonna give it a try. Another goose egg. Big money, no whammy. Big money, no whammy. Let me show you what I got. First, I did pick up that Bosch jigsaw. It's air powered. Now, not all Bosch is created equal. This Bosch is made in Germany. Picked it up for $25, and it should sell for about $150. Now this is a Bosch saw that I paid $45 for, and it'll sell for around $100. It's a little worse of a deal there, but still plenty of profit. Mystery Science Theater 3000 sells for about a $20 bill. I got it for free. I did pick up that little camera for $15, which sells for around $60 or $70. So probably made a good $200 to $300 on that trip. Not bad. Getting to the tail end of my journey. This is one of the last couple of stops. I like this pawn shop. Okay, everybody, that's about a wrap. I hit about a dozen stores. It's a pretty average day, I would say. Pawn shops were a little tough today. Everybody's a little thin on inventory, but we did good at some of the hardware stores we stopped at. And wow, thrift stores were a bust. But what can you do? Sometimes it's a lot of looking and not a lot.